Welcome back, everybody. Game number three now between CDC and Youth and Vici Gaming. Kind of surprising that we are going to a game number three, and even more surprising in how dominant CDC Youth was in game number two, and they also got their hands on the Zeus that they beat LGD with, so maybe things are looking pretty damn good for CDC Youth. I don't know. What do you think, Ryu?
I'm going to be very interested to see how things work. Because there's no roaming heroes this game, and like you said, they've beat people with Zeus, but can you beat a Zeus with OD is going to be the question now. And now they're doing something we talked about in the first game where Night Stalker can completely screw over Beastmaster in his vision game, but the one good thing they do have to fall back on is the Zeus ulti, maybe scouting out for vision. But if you waste a Zeus ulti and the enemy team is smoked, VG could just take that team fight and it could turn really bad for them, but they need to be a little bit careful now. They need to ban out the Spectre in my mind. I think that's just a hero you can't give away when there's a Zeus in the game and Beastmasters. There's just too much global presence. You know, one roar, you're dead with Spectre Haunted. One roar, you're dead with Zeus ulti plus one. So need to respect this global. 5 seconds remaining.
Second set of bans, Finn and Ember Spirit going to be reserve time. Two banned away. I guess at this point, you want to be able to limit heroes that can put pressure on the OD. You've got some really solid lockdown and vision with the Beastmaster. You've got a heavy amount of magic damage from the Zeus. It also seems like a game that could probably go late. I like Spectre here for a CDEC Youth, actually.
Yeah,
I like it a lot.
They just need to ban it out right now from VG. I mean, like you said, there's heroes that have blinks that are really good. I think Juggernaut's actually a really underwhelming hero here against OD. And also Night Stalker, because it kind of forces him to go Manta style. And so he can, you know, Manta off the crippling fear. Mm-hmm. And also you can just Astral somebody who's getting ultied or Astral self and... Yeah, the only thing Juggernaut really adds is pushing power to the lineup of CDC. And Slark was a really good ban for them. Obviously, if you're... 10 seconds the remaining. Zeus is a really good hero for kind of counteracting him because of the static field and the lightning remaining. Bolt can go through the ulti. But at the same time, Beastmaster, it adds more vision game to VG. And then, obviously, you're quick on your fingers. You can just purge off the Beastmaster roar and then... Could be a very big problem for the team fights.
Right. I'm surprised they didn't ban away Faceless Void, though. I think that would have been a nice addition to VG Gaming's lineup, actually, with the OD already in hand. But
have so many tanky heroes, it's just hard to kill them all. And
yeah. And I guess Ember Spirit and Slark would be more of a problem against, against Zeus and Beastmaster in a way. Zeus doesn't provide any lockdown himself, and you've got Beastmaster who does provide some lockdown, but that's where the Slark ban comes in.
Yeah, I like the Slark ban. I'm not too sure about the Ember, just because of the amount of burst damage you can do to an Ember with Zeus and the hero. And we can even have OD being mid or safe lane, but I doubt that in this case. And Wind Ranger, is this like a dual lane or something? Because it's either going to be running as a support now or kind of like in conjunction with
I think it's support Zeus. I believe in one of their games. Yeah, okay. I believe in one of their games against LGD, it was a support Zeus. And then the other, it was mid. So, I don't know.
I guess they just want to change it up since they know Zeus will get absolutely demolished mid. Against an OD, they're just going to change it up.
It's fair enough. VG Gaming.
A hero I would really love right now would be Viper just to soak up all the damage, but it doesn't really fit well with an OD. I feel like...
Are you wanting to see a different mid, or are you wanting OD to go safe lane in this game? It works pretty well against Beastmaster, to be honest.
Yeah, you can just kill those boars so easy. Mm-hmm. It depends on what mid they pick. because I do think they need another core, and I don't think Burning wants to play OD. Like, I feel like he wants to have another hero. Like, yes, the Sark's banned out, so it's really hard for me to think of what other hero. Like, Klinks could be really good in this game.
10 seconds remaining.
Okay, so Radiant this is looking like a Night Stalker offline now, and then OD plus Mirana roaming around the mid lane.
Yeah, because normally the Night Stalker operates in the four position, right? But with a Mirana, that is obviously the roamer. Though Vici Gaming did do that double roaming s sort of thing before, right? With the Beastmaster and or what? Doom and Earth Spirit was what they had.
Yeah, Doom and Earth Spirit.
Yeah. So, double roaming heroes wouldn't be totally out of the question if Night Stalker, say, went Iron Talon first.
You just start roaming at 4 minutes instead of
yeah,
zero.
Exactly. Windranger and Chen, CDC youth, are stocking up for a bit of pushing power now. Between the Beastmaster and Necronomicon, Windranger's Focus Fire, now a Chen.
10 seconds remaining.
They need some wave clear or something. I don't think I don't think Void can be the answer anymore. Batrider is decent here. Okay, that's another decent hero. You needed your support hero. As we talked about, Night Stalker is going to be running that offlane. I was trying to think of some kind of D push, but they're going to use it as their support hero here. Winter Wyvern is going to help out a lot. You just ulti somebody too, and they're going to get attacked by every single thing. And it's could be really nice when you're trying to stay on the back lines and cold embrace somebody when they roar. Remaining. So they have basically two ways to save people. One is the cold embrace plus Glimmer Cape, if they can get that relatively fast on the Winter Wyvern, that could help out a lot. And then they have two. They have the Astral Imprisonment. So they do have ways to deal with the Beastmaster and his lockdown. But when you have a Shackle Shot too, it's gonna be very difficult for VG to necessarily turn all the team fights around. Mm-hmm. I'm curious though, Cap. Who do you favor so far? I really love CDEC's lineup right now, just because of. I mean, it's not single target focus right now. That's what I feel like VG's problem is right now.
That's
why I like the gyro ban. It seems that's a pretty heads up one.
I don't know. I still think the OD is going to be off to a really good start with this OD Mirana combination.
Right.
And then they have, I think the Winter Wyvern was a very appropriate hero against Windranger, Beastmaster, and then the pushing power of Chen. Like, I think, like, there are certain boxes that need to be ticked before Winter Wyvern is a viable support, and they were all, like, single target physical damage. Windranger, okay, check that one. Necronomicon hero, check that one. Any kind of summon hero, check that one as well. Single target lockdown, you got that in the Beastmaster War. Remaining. And then against pushing power, like every single one of those things, Winter Wyvern is amazing.
Oh, yeah,
against.
New
what
hero.
The? All right.
I was gonna say Lycan, but I didn't want to sound crazy.
Yo, you know what's funny? Is troll with OD. You know how absurd that is?
It really is.
Yeah, you're just like, max attack speed, OD, go! And he's just like, womp, 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 womp. He's got intelligence maxed out real quickly. Drops his hammer.
I think Troll's still a really good hero. It adds a lot of pushing potential to their lineup, and it's one of those heroes that can win a lot of 1v1 matchups still because of the Whirling Axes and the missed chances and because of the slows that the... Yeah, I forgot what the ranged axes are called now, if they're still... like, I know Whirling Axes, it's the melee one. What's the ranged one, Cap?
I don't know.
I forgot. Wow, this hero's dead. But yeah, there's the Klinks. Talked about it earlier. I thought they would pick it up, but saving it for last here. Not too many cores left on the field. Great hero to help out a lot against the Chen. Take his army away from him, as well as just roaming around. They need some kind of disruptive hero against CDEC's lineup that can go from the back lines, and they need to free up OD's farm. That's going to be a very tall order for VG, I think.
I
I'm calling it CDC Youth Win. I'm feeling it.
I feel like their mid's not going to go well enough, and their supports are going to get destroyed by Clinks.
Yeah, I could see that happening easily.
But yeah, this is definitely a momentum game. I think we'll have our answer by like what, 15 minutes? You think?
15. Yeah, 15 minutes. At 15 minutes, either VG have one or two tier two towers left, or CDC Youth are just down by like 10 or 15 kills.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's exactly the metrics to look at. VG Gaming gonna go for pickoffs and kills. CDC pushing down towers like crazy. I am most concerned about this support Zeus, but I really shouldn't be, I guess, because they beat LGD with it. So
you beat all those no names, or those, I mean, not no names, those, jeez, I'm so mean, those famous people on the team, and then you just get a lot of recognition, and he's going to get the ward off? No, I thought he would.
HYM?
All right.
Like, he's old. If he didn't have boots first, right, I think he would have to level leap.
Yes, he
That's
would.
How absurd he would, because it's just like, he would guarantee die otherwise. I have no idea what that was.
He wanted to put the ward right here. If I could, do you see my ping? Yeah.
Oh, you mean it? Oh, at that one?
Yeah. He wanted to put the ward there.
Why did you place it here though, against a Beastmaster? I like that one.
30 seconds yeah. to battle. Yeah. I think he just wanted this one up here just to know when he rotated to top lane, if he was hiding, like say over here, or something, or hiding here in the trees, or right. anywhere.
Easy arrows. Well. She will head all the way back to base. It's kind of interesting. We're on a 4 position with boots, 3 clarities, was given a shared tango. The battle begins. Just so he doesn't have to immediately go back to base if he runs into a hero like Beastmaster again after the horn blows.
It's so funny how he's missing out on the block mid. It's kind of like it was forced for JDH to go there, and now that could maybe free up a little bit of time for a DD in the offlane here. And this is really good now, because this range creep is in front. This hurts VG so much in the early game for that screw up.
Yeah, Burning, he just can't seem to block enough for his range creep to go forward, so.
So we lag.
Good start. Good start for the Beastmaster. We'll see, though, how mid goes. Windrager's going to have to play so careful in this matchup. Can't get too close. Otherwise, he gets imprisoned. And they don't have any wards. Wait, where's their other ward? For Radiant's side.
I think maybe they...
Oh, they still have it. The Chen just hasn't placed it yet.
Yeah.
HYM? What are you doing here?
He's,
is he going
to
kill the
troll?
No!
Wrecked.
Why did he show himself, though? He could have just, like, waited and killed the troll with an arrow that way. Yeah, and now he misses out on a potential arrow at mid, where the imprisonment's already been laid down.
This is a harder one to kill, though. If you can time it right, you'll get to your win run off most of the time in the mid lane here. But if you time it perfectly and he's in the middle...
I don't think you can, actually, though. If the arrow's, like, on top of the imprisonment when you come back up.
Yeah, it's got to be, like, perfectly in the middle, I think. Yeah. We'll have to see, because, like you said, you can dodge, or you can't dodge it in most cases, but so it has to be perfect. If not, 1 second too late, 1 second.
Oh my God, Victoria is so smart.
Yeah, going around here.
Yeah, with the he smokes up, but he leaves the skeletons in mid, so they're gonna be able to actually catch the OD, and this should be our. Oh, the arrow actually lands. Are they gonna be able to kill the Windranger first? Oh my God, they are. Windranger goes down. Should still be enough right clicks to be able to finish off the OD, but I guess good arrow coming out in time. The skeletons didn't draw just enough time away from that Morana. Meanwhile, our Beastmaster died. That should not have happened. But
it's burning. He went for this amazing build early on. He went for Strafe. You don't normally expect that.
What?
You just don't expect it.
Oh my God! What happened? Like, was Beastmaster like? Did he go for a CS and then it was like Strafe and slow? Because he didn't even have boots at that time.
Yeah, he was over here contesting the pool, and then all of a sudden they just kind of converged on him and easy mid kill.
That's
again.
Hilarious.
I saw that at the end.
I was drawing your. I was watching your drawings. Wind Ranger, down again in that mid lane. Kind of what we expected, though. That first blood was obviously. I mean, it should have been all about mid lane, but go you, Burning. Victorious now going to rotate over with his Chen creeps. Time to go for a push and maybe catch out R2K in the process. They slow him down with the range axes, trying to catch up in range. Oh, that mini stun was just enough. Nice silence there on the centaur, but it doesn't really matter. It was quick thinking, but it wasn't enough, that's for sure. They get the kill and are not going for the push, actually. Victoria, despite a successful rotation, I thought they'd put pressure on the tower, but they're going to keep this game rather fast-paced. They know that HYM is always going to be around that mid lane, so they're going to try and gank it. They will be able to successfully surround HYM. The net still goes down, and an arrow from Windranger will get some vengeance. Meanwhile, top lane, our Beastmaster is forced away from the lane, trying to secure an arcane rune, it looks like, for the Windranger.
Poor guy. I'm looking at Windranger. He's not even close to a bottle. So he's just kind of forced to take it. He got the haste rune too here. This will help out a lot. If he wants to pull, he can maybe make a cheeky play and pull the creeps off the tower and or from here.
RTK playing a game of Ring Around the Rosy. RTK knows those games, though. He literally just sat there. He was like, I'll let you come to me. You didn't need that. Didn't matter, though. RTK is forced away as the Zeus returns back to lane after getting that 4-minute rune. Yeah, Beastmaster is still level 4, though. Comparatively, he's a bit behind RTK. He's doing quite well for himself in this Nightstalker.
Yeah, he could even get a solo kill if he wants to pop the Mango. Problem is that Friday just shows up. Where's...
It's called Whirling Axes, by the way. It's just range form.
Okay. I was, man, I'm just lagging every 2 seconds now. It's making my brain lag. I'm like, what is happening in this game? Freaking perfect world. It's putting me on tilt.
Yeah. JDH being run down by double boars. Is he actually dead here? He doesn't have Cold Embrace yet. Oh, God, he barely gets over the trees, but a boar hit comes into play just in time and Burning. He's actually slowed down by the boar venom still, so he can't get ahead of the Beastmaster. Won't be able to get the return kill at all.
That's a really good play, diving in. That gets him his level 5. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, HYM has been setting in the Roche Pit. He pokes his head out. They might want to make a play here.
Is he going to throw an arrow? No. Misses out there. Friday just turns it with the Whirling Axes. That bit of aggression is done.
Top rune. We'll see what CTY gets. Only a bounty rune. But we have to look at the CS here in the mid lane, how crippling it is for the Wind Ranger. I thought it would be 10 times worse. I thought it would be like 12 to 30 right now. But considering she still is keeping up a little bit, that's hopeful. Still, HYM. Lucky dog, you get a freaking invis rune. Not even fair.
So he's going to position himself behind the Windranger. Trying to get the close range arrow. Or wait for the imprisonment. He's got the troll on the right side. Oh, HYM. I think he was afraid that the troll was actually going to run in front of the arrow. They throw it now, but oh no. Windranger runs back at the perfect time. He slew that troll, though. Got him.
That's free gold. He needed it. He's already got his arcane boots, though. I'm kind of curious to see what he'll go for next on this support Morana. I mean, they need to have a mechanism in their game, so most likely go that mid arrow. Oh, it's gonna hit! No wait, it didn't. Fucking perfect world back, man. This is making me mad. It looked like it hit on my screen.
Oh, I wasn't even watching. I checked out bottom lane. All he heard was, who spoiled my shot?
It literally went right.
All
right,
he's going to go on JDH, I think, but it is a bit of a bait. Burning's going to pop his head out. We'll slow down the Beastmaster with the extra bit of strafe attack speed. It's still not enough. They didn't get the nuke either. So
that's
Beastmaster gets away.
I didn't even see the particle from the Splinter Blast. So it missed, you said?
Yeah. If it landed, they probably get that kill with the extra slow.
Yep. It's surprised he didn't pop it a little bit earlier.
Yeah, that was definitely on him.
But this is favoring CDEC youth so much right now. It's because it's daytime. It is daytime. Night Stalker didn't get anything accomplished. He did get a lot of levels. And
yeah, he... That was kind of interesting. I expected ROTK to... I mean, he's playing Night Stalker. I expected ROTK to run at you, but he really stuck it out in lane. And they're now going to make a rotation into... Is this to Roshan? An attempt at Roshan? But they're not going to find it. They get the dust burning. He's been hit by that one, but not slowed enough. Level 2 Skeleton Walk is going to be enough, but he had to pop open. That's going to be a roar out, and they will be able to get this kill on Burning as Friday cuts his way across.
That did look like a Rosh attempt, but instead they get a free Clinks. Yeah. I wonder what they would have rather had, though. At the end of the day, I think that's still good for the Clinks to go down.
Yeah, I think they'd rather have the Clinks.
Yeah.
Just because they can transition this into Tier 1, and they still have, obviously, amazing Roshan potential. It was a pretty cool attempt at a Roshan, though, right? Because that was three heroes off-map that you expect to be off-map. The Beastmaster and the Windranger, or rather, the Troll and the Windranger, who are both good at doing Roshan, would have been in lane, and I don't think VG Gaming would have suspected that Roshan
was going on.
Oh my god,
the RTK dying.
Jesus.
To the
Shard Golems.
The boulders.
Yeah. They got to be able to take that tower. It's also daytime, so everything should be good.
This is the pressure you want to have. You need to rotate and make sure you take down that bottom tier 1 tower. This is what they lacked in the first game for CDEC. You have to take away these towers so that VG can't get Rosh themselves. They have a really good Rosh lineup themselves, honestly. Bottom arrow for 5 seconds and the Arcane Orb plus the fire arrows. It's really good.
Boogie
top
up. Goes down. Try to get some experience, but Burning is quick to jump on that one. Oh, the arrow nails him. Beastmaster is going to be TP'd on and should easily go down Friday. He tried to push back HYM, but now he's got to get himself out of there.
Kind of a waste of an ulti from CTY. Maybe he thought there was a lot more people around and... wanted to ensure the kill before he got the roar off, but
it could be also just wanted the kill. It is pretty important for OD, I think, to get his get the last hit on these kills, because that fast rod of Atos makes a world of difference when it comes to that mid game power of the OD.
Yep, I agree. He needs to get the last hits, but if they try and force down towers now, not having these big ultimates online could be hurting. The one good thing is JDH. We talked about it last game. He was like level 5 on ES at like 20 minutes or 18 minutes still when they called GG or something crazy. But
yeah,
he's level 7 now. And that's the perfect place you want to be at. You just need to have your max Winter Bass for the D push. And then you need your Winter's Curse online. So they're in a very good position. They're scouting him out. They know where he is. He should be dead here.
War goes down. The nukes of the Zeus make this pretty easy for them. Dire's top tower is under attack. They'll keep on going straight into the tier 1. Again, these kind of smoke rotations where you get a pick off, take a tower. This is CDEC, the traditional CDEC at its finest. And the youth team clearly taking some notes here. The smoke up from VG Gaming, they've laid a nice trap against CDEC, and they will be able to catch at least one. The arrow lands on Lugia, and that'll be a secondary kill. The Shackle Shot gets laid out, but that'll do nothing to stop Burning, who takes the double kill.
Man, relatively very close game here. They did defend their top tower. Really well played coming in from VG. That smoke.
Oh, nice shard there and a good stomp. Doesn't quite hit CTY, though. And this will probably mean the Chen, rather, goes down. Nukes of the Winter Wyvern, our knife. A nice shackle shot. They have some follow-up stuns, but no real damage. Windranger's actually got to be careful. Never mind. Burning doesn't really care about you at all. He just wants to take these towers. I like this. The focus of the towers by VG Gaming, making sure that CDEC youth, who do have the push lineup that's going to be able to take up early objectives, don't get too big of a net worth lead as VG Gaming manage to force some towers of their own. Moonlight Shadow will make sure that ROTK easily survives there.
Probably why we don't see Troll too much. He's just such a weird hero. They kind of are forced to group up, and at the same time, this Night Stalker is doing a lot of work. He's just silencing people left and right. It's the second nighttime. This is where RTK is going to be coming online fully. And we talked about it. Once you have this nighttime online, the Hawk is going to... Oh, they have Burning.
Smart play from Beastmaster. He's baiting out Burning right now. They knew that VG Gaming was going to try and collide on him. He's just on the edge, but it doesn't really matter with the Zeus here. That was perfect. That was another one of those setups from VG Gaming, kind of copying what CDC were doing. They're using the Klinx now to be that kind of ganking, rotating hero, and he gets killed, then turns it into a fast tower. But CDC Youth had the read on that one. Slow down the push. VG Gaming, though, keeping up this tempo, rotating to the bottom lane, and I think they're going to try and take that tier 1 at bottom, at least get some chip damage on it, in exchange for top tower going down, obviously.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see where Burning TPs to when he comes back alive. If he wants to pressure the bottom tower, or if they want to go for Rosh. So this will... Who's going to pick it up is the question. Yeah, Odie has to pick it up.
Oh, yeah. And Aegis. And Aegis OD is probably one of the most dangerous heroes.
Oh, yeah. Two lives. But I don't know. Burning's died a lot. Got to give it to him now. He's only died twice. And this is just a trait. It's very unfortunate to have it happen, but they do have a really good Rosh lineup this game from VG. Medallion already on Burning, and this is going to help him too. Quickly get up to that Desolator for his next item, and two lives on OD, trying to figure out how they're going to burst through that. It's going to be very difficult. Maybe if you get, you know, permabashed, there's hope, but...
Yeah. So the gold and net worth are the net worth and experience leads, not too big in the favor of VG Gaming, but this is still, I mean, if it's even or slightly to the favor of VG Gaming, I think it's VG Gaming's game. CDC Youth definitely need to put this push lineup into overdrive, but they can't against the Aegis, or at least it's definitely a lot more dangerous now.
Way dangerous against the Aegis. Unless you find CTY kind of farming alone, playing really aggressive, then it's going to be very hard to pick him off twice. And mid lane. Ooh, nice blink out.
So at the
beginning, Windranger has no DPS. Sometimes we see the Maelstrom, just so you have some sort of DPS to, and then you rush the Blink Dagger. But in this case, he's just rushing him. He's like, all right, well, I already have Focus Fire. I have Troll's ulti. Speaking of Troll, he's probably going to be picked off here.
Night Shadow leading the way. Friday is going to be able to get back to his base and underneath his tier 1 tower. Zeus pops the ultimate. They see the rest of these heroes. They're going to try and focus down the tier 1. Oh, the TP away's not in time, though. Friday is going to die. So good rotation from VG Gaming. Using the Klinx to scout things out. Meanwhile, Windranger obviously trying to threaten the middle tier 1, but it doesn't quite happen. This top lane, CDECU, I think this is perhaps maybe a little bit inexperienced or something, but they're spending so much time waiting for the pickoff at the top lane that they're just stalling out now. They could have like been threatening that tier 2 while the dive was happening at bottom lane or something, but they were waiting so long to catch JDH pushing out the lane, they never got him. And they didn't get anything really to turn this game to their favor.
Yep, just a little bit of experience. They were just farming the jungle instead of pressuring. And it's good and bad at the same time, but you really have to pressure the towers when you know Glyph is down. And maybe that's just why they backed off. They were worried because the Glyph did go out like 50 seconds ago, and they're like, okay, well, they could be setting up here. But instead, they immediately were smoke ganking the bottom lane. And They just need to try to go around, get pickoffs. It's daytime. This is when you have to make stuff happen. If ROTK just manages to find his eggs, it's going to be very hard for CDC to ever take a team fight. Oh, man, a Solar Crest. Oh, they have eyes, ROTK.
Shackle, but he's pretty damn tanky. He's going to be able to turn around, gets out the silence. And that'll be enough for him to be able to escape. Even a power shot won't be able to finish off. RTK. He actually turns around with that arrow being thrown out. He is going to be able to catch the Wind Ranger. Wind Ranger with no TP here is not going to be able to escape unless he somehow jukes and jives long enough for Blink to come up. Oh, power shot, Blink. Oh, he's getting away. Burning Season, though, the Rod of Atos is there, and they will catch him. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, Winter Wyvern does get caught near the Ancients area. Looks like he wanted to get a ward up. And while he was successful in his endeavor, he does give up his life in the process.
Yeah, good trade-off. And they're not even pushing the bottom tower. They're just leaving Burning there. They're just going for more pickoffs. Moonlight Shadow, such good play from VG right now. Rip
this
Chen.
This is a dire count award, so it doesn't really matter. They just run at Victoria. Troll will get the tier 2 in top lane. Something. They've managed to keep this tier 1 for way longer, I think, than they should have.
Mid tower is should have been dead a long time ago, but we still have the carry Zeus. There's no worries for a CDC. They beat LGD, like you said. There's hope, but it's slowly fading away where they have 4,000 gold lead accumulated now and with the last Aegis here. Mm-hmm. But it's slowly running out here, and now is the time where maybe you want to... Oh, they have Friday. Jesus.
Well, that's no good.
Yeah, he has to go BKB now, just immediately. That's the problem with Troll Warlord. He's like a weaker Sven. He just takes way too long to farm, and it's just not beneficial at all. You can't even stack to do the Ancients. You can't really do anything. Your best hope is to take the Roche early on, and they didn't do it. So at least they will get the ward out of this.
Or will they? Burning. Nah. He's going to kill Lugia just as the ward goes down. Still, though, farther down, Silence on the Wind Ranger. CTY being kept back by the Chen creeps, though. 9-13, 20 minutes in. Vici Gaming with a pretty good lead. Looking to use this darkness time to put some more pressure on CDC Youth. They're taking over the jungle. They don't quite yet have, I don't know, you think Burning at this point, he would the completed Solar Crest? I think it's almost too much to go Desolator when you've gone all the way into the Solar Crest. Do you think he should go straight MKB against this Wind Ranger?
Honestly, I think he still needs a BKB. Just because of the burst damage coming in from Zeus. And if he gets roared without his BKB on and Necro 3 on top of him, he's just going to die.
Yeah.
And that's the biggest problem. But at the same time, you do have the Solar Crest, so you get a lot of evasion coming in. So he might think he's survivable enough to...
All right, TK leading the charge. They are going to throw out the Primal Roar on him, but the Imprisonment save is there. And Vici Gaming smoke doesn't actually turn out the way they want it to. Einstalker may still end up dying here. The next Lightning Bolt coming back in 2 seconds. That would be enough to finish him off, but a power shot lands instead. Nice snipe there from the Wind Ranger. Shackle shot not going to land, though. So that'll be the end of the engagement. Vici Gaming smoke ends in a loss of the Nightstalker.
Rip Nightstalker. Really well. But it's still, they're making aggressive plays, and they forced them to use Roar, they forced them to use all their ultis, and it still could be go time if they really want to. It's just risking a lot, though. Probably need to wait for Nightstalker to come back up, and then they should just keep putting the pressure on. I wanted to talk about something a little bit earlier. I'll hold that thought as I wait for Burning to see what he wants to do here.
You're going to see some heroes. Wind Ranger gets the Shackle Shot on a JDH. The arrow comes in, does land on the Wind Ranger, but obviously with 5 heroes of CDC, there's nothing Burning can do about that one.
Yeah, easy pickoff. Finally taking back their jungle. This is something a lot of teams have a hard time doing, and CDC have kind of perfected it. Baited out the mid tower, and then now getting up some good vision here. So really well played so far, kind of nudging their way back into this game. And I wanted to touch a little bit on the pick. Oh god, not again, another kill onto Friday.
Yeah, he is just not having a great game.
Woo, that troll pick. No.
Yeah, but it's definitely not working.
Troll battle trance with Wind Ranger ulti. I mean, you already max attack speed, so the synergy is awful. It's atrocious. So it just basically helps out, I guess, with the Beastmaster. And here, converging mid lane.
They do have the backup here. The rest of CDCU. The Silence goes down first on the Beastmaster, unable to get off that Primal Roar. And as the Windrun runs out, our Windranger now exposed does end up going down. Burning's going to look for more. Lugia tries to go for the TP out, but a Winter's Curse puts a stop to that one. Now casually right-click him down on the left side. Nightstalker is still running at that Beastmaster. The arrow gets thrown out and lands. No, it doesn't actually land on the Beastmaster. Slides right on past him, but they should be able to go for the dive. The Primal Roar turnaround. RTK is actually going to go down as the Troll comes back into play. The gem is dropped on the deck. Friday wants to be able to pick that one up, is going to be able to grab it now as Burning is forced back by the Chen creeps and the Necronomicons. Nice decision there by CTY, actually forcing the melee Necronomicon out of sight, Radiant's meaning that the Klinks is able to get away under his invis once again.
This is, I mean, that was really good at the beginning. That was the first time we saw Winter's Curse, I feel like, and it was only in 1 year to stop the TP.
Oh, so yeah.
We haven't seen the effectiveness of JDH this game at all, but still, the rest of his heroes are playing really well, and they got the gem on their side. This is going to help out a lot. And if VG want to have map control, they're just going to have to wait another, how long? Another 7 minutes to get back the gem and buy it. Because I think CDEC, they're just going to put the gem in the base. There's no reason for them to even have it walking around. They have Zeus to zap around. They have Necro 3s running around. No point in holding on gem.
Zodi is so hard to kill. You agree with Lincoln's over BKB?
Oh, that's a really good choice. It's good and bad. One is it's like getting a Lincoln's against a PA. It's like she has Stifling Dagger. Why the hell are you doing that? And it's so far away. It's kind of the same logic. You have Arc Lightning. It's like, why are you doing that? But
right.
At the same time, most of the time, Beastmaster or Windranger is going to be jumping in on the front lines, and Zeus isn't going to be necessarily there to cancel it. Mm-hmm. So it'll help out a lot. Maybe putting it on Burning while he's sieging the high ground. Just have to be very careful. It's not just wasted by, you know, like I was talking about, an Arc Lightning.
Chen is getting closer to that Ags or Zeus. They're making Zeus by all the items. Yeah, it seems like it. Got that Aether Lens, but he has got nothing since. Ghost Scepter. Well, guess that's something.
Yeah, I would really like for him to have the Force Staff, but it's just kind of hard. Also, Yules is really good in this game for purging off the Silence and, you know, on the retreat. That's the biggest thing. Like, you're retreating a lot right now if you're CDC. You're just, like, trying to get the hell out of Dodge and get back to base so you can live. Oh, mid lane. Here we go. Where's my bottom? No bottom.
No follow-up. Can't believe CDC Youth haven't been able to do much here. The 5 minutes. Time to rotate up. See if they can get a quick pickoff. Definitely need it to be able to offset the Aegis advantage that VG Gaming has right now. CTY jumps in, setting up the arrow. Lands beautifully on the Windranger. Does manage to get off the Windrun, though, and that means the death will be slow, but it'll happen eventually. Actually, the Winter's Curse getting laid out and still not happening. Finally, Burning is able to get that damage in. Now they'll pop Darkness. Throw down the arrow. Takes out that melee Necronomicon for some gold.
Rip my chin. Rip Victoria. I knew you will.
Victoria's definitely not getting
we
out of here.
We can date in the next life. But, yeah, at least that, I couldn't tell. Could you, since I was lagging during that team fight, where was he at?
It was a little bit forward, but
okay.
It was still, I mean, what I thought was going to be an instant situation, but he still managed to get off the win run.
Okay, so yeah. I'm just trying to confirm it for myself, too. It's a really nice. Oh, top, bottom. Yeah, got him. All right, well, my Zeus, it was nice knowing you.
Very, very, very dead. And the big physical damage dealer is still middle, where they're going to be able to get the tier 2 tower. This is how you know the VG Gaming have a very sizable lead. If you can't tell from the net worth, it's because VG Gaming are ahead in towers, and this is against a push lineup. So
easy.
The Wind Ranger is super poor.
Oh, yeah. They just completely shut her down in the mid lane. It was like you talked about. Oh, yeah, that they won. Good game, CDC Youth.
The comeback.
Nice, they're moving on. DDoS, easy.
The comeback is real.
They should just unpause and play. Maybe they'll get a little bit ahead.
It's the only way back.
Honestly,
because late game troll isn't the same as late game Sven, right? It's just
no.
It's just not as good.
You would have at this situation, troll would have about 20k, or no, that Sven would have 20k net worth, somewhere around there. Let's see Odie's score right now, 7-1, maybe 17k. It's just you would constantly stack and farm, and troll just can't do that. He's just forced to kind of play the split push game, get towers, get Roche.
VG Gaming's in a team house together, right?
I don't know.
They are.
Well, I mean, if you know everything, Cap, that's good for you. I mean, when you have new teams kind of formed together, sometimes it's better that you're actually in a team house. Like, sometimes you don't like playing with people when you know their habits in real life, or you don't like talking to them or something. So that's to let you know how a team really acts together if they like being around each other. That helps out a lot. So maybe since the reshuffle, some teams have gone to the house together and are practicing a lot more.
Time to go for the... Oh, they haven't actually taken the tier 1 at top lane yet. Jesus. I mean, the funny thing is about that is that those tower towers are pretty inconsequential. They're like the easier towers to take if you're VG Gaming. So they don't have as big of a tower advantage as I thought. But they have a huge map control advantage, and they've taken all the important towers, the mid ones first, and now taking that tier 2 at the bottom lane.
It just feels so underwhelming for Radiant side to invade the Dire jungle. Whereas if you're Dire and you invade the Radiant jungle, that makes it so that one, we get wards down, we know where they're farming, and we can do Roche really easily. It's just a big discrepancy when you're prioritizing which jungles to kind of take over at what times. But interesting to see what Burning will go for next. He saved up 2,500. I think he might have gone Blink Dagger already. A positioning with Clinks
Blink
is really
forward.
Good.
The arrow's going to come out. Boars die as they tank that one up. The Shackle Shot lands on OD, but I highly doubt they're going to be able to go on him as rest of Ichi Gaming is sitting right behind. Burning is the only one who's not there, and he's just casually pushing out the top lane. Looks like he's going to go for the back door on the tier 1. He may be caught by the Beastmaster if he tries something ballsy as that, though. So he actually goes back to pushing out the lane. I think he figured, like, yeah, that's probably a bit unnecessary.
Good call. That's one of those moments where you're like, if that tower was at 400 HP, Clinks dies. Yeah. So Burning is pretty lucky that the tower is at 4 HP right now. Else, you normally do make those greedy plays.
Don't mind if I do.
Regeneration. They don't have the gem yet, right? Beastmaster has a gem. I was actually taking. Oh, that's right. They lost that one fight, and JDH ended up giving. RTK ended up losing JDH's gem.
Yeah, DDD. So he didn't put the gem on him until he got the Blink Dagger because he didn't feel safe walking around with it.
Yeah, that's.
But now he feels a bit more.
How long until VG Gaming can buy a gem again? Because that kind of seals it. 50 seconds. Because how do you, like, you've lost so many towers, you can't really fight VG Gaming that well. They always have the evasion advantage, and that is kind of secured once they have the gem on ROTK again.
You're just going to have to hope that you get a really good smoke initiation. That's going to be the biggest thing. Because they do have the initiation tools that VG don't. Like, you have Blink, Shackle, Blink, Roar. But at the same time, we've talked about how VG can easily save heroes. Like, with the Astral, with Winter Wyvern's Embrace, and you can always turn around with a Curse just to buy more time. So it's still going to be hard for CDC to burst the targets.
Mid lane. Oh, Hawk spies out ROTK. Beastmaster kind of wanted to get some vengeance for his Hawk, but can't get close enough. ROTK playing the spacing game beautifully while Burning addresses the Chen push. I guess they can just casually wait it out, right? You can farm up an MKB on Klinks. You could still get a Scythe of Ice on the OD as well as the Shivas. This is game number three, after all. You don't want to in the loser's bracket on top of that, so you don't want to take any unnecessary risks. Allow CDCU to get back in this game.
Yeah. I guess the bigger thing is, what are we waiting for VG that could be very scary from CDC? It's not too much. You have two huge cores that are going to do a lot more work at the end of the day than the Troll and the Windranger. Don't get me wrong, I think Windranger can be the strongest late game carries, if not one of them. You just have to have, you know, Daedalus and, you know, MKB, BKB, but you have to get on top of the targets, in which case she's so far behind. She's fifth in network, or fourth now. She just got some CS, my bad, guys. But, yeah, she still needs to have a BKB, else she's just going to keep getting Astral'd and Arrowed in the face, and that can't happen to your huge damage dealer at this stage of the game.
Smoke away. Burning's off on his Lonesome in the mid lane. There's MKB. He can actually be pretty close to solo killing the Windranger, but they're actually going to have some help as CTY makes his rotation over. They start focusing down the Troll as the rest of the heroes are too hard to hit with the Ghost Scepters. Good Jackal Shot. Burning is actually going to lose this man fight. Friday walks away with the win. CTY is actually being blocked up by the Windranger, but as Windrun falls, CTY actually gets the easy kill. Drops the hammer on the Chen for not the Chen. A little bit of lag there. Chen still ends up going down, though. Yeah, that Troll. That is one thing. Troll against an OD. This is a hero that has no intelligence naturally. So unless you're getting an early Scotty or something, that Sanity's Eclipse is always going to do absurd amounts of damage.
Yeah, look at that. 200 right now, rocking 210-ish with the plus 35 intelligence. And then you have only 40 on the Troll. My goodness. Yeah, this is looking pretty much over, too. Even if the Troll jumps on you, too, you can just Astral yourself and wait for backup and wait out his BKB. And because he has the Shiva's guard, he's just so tanky. And
yep, what is Beastmaster doing? Beastmaster, you didn't have Primal Roar yet, buddy. Okay.
He thought he did, Cap. Come on, it was up in one second. He just...
Then you start spamming out. Meep merp, meep merp, meep merp.
That's pretty annoying when you play. It's like, I'm sorry, team.
So bad. He could have gotten the kill on OD, though, if he just waited out.
That would have been a big turnaround. They need to find a way to kill the OD. 10-1. It feels like he hasn't died once this game. But TTY picking up that moon shard. The world is his oyster. Anything he wishes can come true. And then obviously we talked about it enough. Klinks already picked up the MKB. And this is going to be cheese now going for the way of VG. If CDC don't contest this right now, it's all over. I don't know how they're going to contest. I wonder what he's going to drop, TTY. Probably should drop his treads.
I mean,
still pick up Aegis.
Yeah, I was about to say, you could just eat the Moon Shard, pick up the Aegis.
Nah, you don't need that. I've seen a lot more crazy stuff. But he's got a lot of mobility, too, without having boots normally. You can catch up with a Rod of Atos on somebody, blink in, Shiva's Guard, slow them down. But yeah, Tread's still pretty good. eating the moon shard. I just wanted him to play super greedy. That's what CC White likes to do.
That's true.
All right, a high ground push incoming. HYM. I'm waiting for the blink forward CTY imprisonment. Because you know it's like it's going to happen eventually. The Lincolns goes down on him. Shackle shot. Thrown out, but a Lotus Orb is quick response. Melee racks for free. Primal Roar. JDH ends up getting caught, but that's still Primal Roar and Necronomicon used. Vici Gaming will just back up. I mean, pretty glad. That trade is well worth it for them.
Yep. And they can even contest the next high ground here once the Winter Wyvern comes back off. They still have all their things to work with. They have the superior map vision, too, so Friday could be in trouble for anybody who stays out here. They have great vision. Oh, no. Not my Zeus.
Zeus is dead once again. Prismant won't kill him, but a right click will. And now the hunt for more. I mean, they'll be a four-man crew, but if they really wanted to escape, they should have TP'd already. Unfortunately, they just didn't have TP, so they get them now. But, oh, God. There is that Sanity's Eclipse showing itself once again against a troll. Imagine Beastmaster blinked to the trees there.
He would have definitely died. He knew exactly where to blink to know that, hey, he's following me. Night Stalker's coming. Can't hide. Yeah. So at least that's one good thing, not giving another free pickoff. But as I say that, maybe in the mid lane here, you already used Windrun.
Windrun doesn't matter. Pew, pew, pew.
Yeah, that's... that's the worst part, too, when you have crippled plus the MKB already finished for burning.
Yeah. Windrun is affected by Rod of Atos, right?
Yes. No. Yeah. I think it's like 80% or something, or 90% chance. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Can't do the math right now, but...
it's the target 40% accuracy. Oh, Lincolns. Oh, no. Wrong time to lag. Burning. Oh, they managed to get the bounce back there. The Burning's still going to be able to get away. Lotus Orb, well positioned, but CTY actually gets bashed up. May end up losing his Aegis here. As he is. Shackle shot. Bounces back. No kill just yet. Friday. It's going to be Winter's Curse. The rest of Ichi Gaming start setting themselves up.
No buyback troll. That's all but seals the fate. That was a good freeze frame,
yeah,
too.
They called it. So, Vici Gaming, they will, as kind of predicted from game number one, move on in this series. It's the next round of the Losers Bracket. CDC Youth, they put up a really good show. I mean, they beat LGD 2-0. They took a game off of Vici Gaming earlier, even if it was like a little bit of a wonky draft. I think you see some things that stand out. I think Lugia played pretty well. Friday was definitely, I think, one of the players
Spirit
that was really lacking.
One, yeah, Ember Spirit game one, very lacking. And then this game, I don't know if it's necessarily his troll play lacking, just maybe just the hero. But
yeah.
If this was Dire Side for CDEC, I'm 90% sure they would have won. 90% sure. Just because they would have gotten three Roshas, I feel,
yeah,
instead of for VG, because they would have been able to put out a lot of pressure. The thing is, they managed to take down two or three two towers before VG could. It's just that they got this one pick off on the bottom lane, and then they transitioned it really effectively into the easy Rosh early on. So. Mm-hmm. I do feel like the side advantage did take a little bit of part in this deciding game, but it was really well played coming in from VG just all around. We didn't get to see too many big Winter Wyvern ulties, but at the end of the day, all the supports kind of did their job, and it was just a kind of clean victory all the way around for VG this time.
All right. Well, that's just it for our first series of the day. We do have another series coming up. It is going to be VG Gaming Reborn versus CDECA. So I hope you guys will join us for that one. That is coming up. It's coming up in 34 minutes. So VG Gaming Reborn versus CDC Avengers coming up next.